Welcome to CS++, the video series where we are trying to make computer science as accessible as possible. And in this episode, I am going to answer the question of what is an operating system? At the most fundamental level, an operating system tells your computer what to do. Now, that's a pretty simplistic look at things. In another episode, I've discussed what the components of a computer are, and it basically tells them how to talk to each other. Now, I know that this is incredibly high level, so I'm going to break it down just a tiny, tiny bit. Basically, your computer turns on, and it has amnesia. It has no idea what it was last doing. And so it has to get instructions from somewhere. And in this process of looking for its instructions, it hopefully finds the operating system. This is what we also call the OS. And then the operating system restores state, initializes hardware, and lets you interact with the computer. That's the operating system's job. You are using operating systems all the time. You are using one right now. Android is an operating system. You say, I have an Android phone, you might not think about it, but you're talking about the actual operating system that's running on that phone. Linux is an operating system. This one is used on, I think, virtually every server that exists on the planet today. There are many, many varieties of Linux. Windows is an operating system. You might be watching this video on a Windows device. iOS is the operating system that's used on iPhone and the iPad. macOS is the Apple operating system if you own a Macintosh. Then there are virtually uncountably many more esoteric operating systems that have found their use in many industries and on personal computers, but you just don't hear about them as often. Such as FreeBSD, OpenBSD, these are used on a lot of devices as well. Haiku is an open source operating system. Serenity OS, again, another. Most of these are open source, actually. macOS and Windows and iOS are not open source. Android, Linux, the BSDs, Haiku, and Serenity are all open source. But that's a topic for a different time. This is a good moment to call out the idea of Unix. And I'm not going to get into what Unix is specifically, but I'm just going to say that all of these operating systems are a flavor of Unix. FreeBSD, Linux, macOS, and OpenBSD. And then it's worth noting that Android and Linux are closely tied together. And they're also related. Anyhow, that is definitely an aside as far as this video is concerned, but let's get back to this. You turn on your computer, it has no idea what to do. It forgets everything that it was last doing when you turned it off, so it goes looking for instructions. Hopefully, it finds an operating system. Sometimes, you might get an error that says operating system missing, and that's not great. If it loads the operating system correctly, it restores your state in some way, it reinitializes your hardware, and it allows you to interact with your computer. That is what an operating system does. So let's not forget our homework this time. What operating systems do you use? You probably are using two or three different operating systems, depending on how your life is organized. Between your cell phone, your laptop, your tablet, your desktop, whatever devices you might own. Search for Esoteric Operating System and see what different interesting examples you can find, and click through some of the screenshots and see why people might use these different operating systems that you've never heard of before.